Might that have a surprise in store, too?
Zurbriggen this winter, second three times, first twice. Unbelievable record. I think he'd trade all of those for a win.
Almost 2 miles away and 2 minutes away.
10 seconds.
One thing about Zurbriggen, he'll risk everything up here. That's what sets him apart. He really turns through these big ones. He's the only one that can really carve those skis through here. He knows he's going to have to ski well up here if he's going to beat Muller. He doesn't have Muller's weight for that extra speed on the bottom. He looked good up on the top.
How is he doing in comparison to Muller? Here's an early check. He's right there with him.
But only by 500ths of a second. That extra push that makes it for Zurbriggen. Oh, he cuts his hand right to the snow. I don't think he lost much time, though. It's so steep and icy up there. Gotta be careful not to fight these turns too much down here.
Zurbriggen has increased his lead. Look at the speed, 82.9.
This could be one of the great classic events of all time. Muller at the bottom, Zurbriggen on the course. He was concerned about breaking that other pair earlier this week in training.
His lead is bigger still.
Oh, now he's really moving. It looks like he does have a fast pair of skis. Now what a run Zurbriggen is having up here. You can see him sitting on the back of his skis, looking for extra speed. He was perfect off that bump. Absolutely perfect.
The lead is still his, but not as big. He can see the finish line from here.
But he is flying. This is going to be a close one.
Zurbriggen, who has had everything in his career except an Olympic medal, and now he has that.
He's got it. What a victory. What a victory. There's more to come, but I don't think anybody can beat Zurbriggen.
Peter Muller sees as defeat.
Peter, you have nothing to feel ashamed of. You turned in a great run.